It's been a pretty tough beat, but we are finally making it to the edge of the island. Let's go. Gentlemen never sail to weather. It's entirely unsophisticated.
This is the story of a sailboat, a dream, and the commitment to do your best and see where it leads. Today we are sailing the Caribbean. One day we will cross the ocean and sail Chuckle home to Greece. Subscribe and join us while we travel by sailboat and learn by experience. Facing fear, finding adventure, and falling in love.
Good morning, beautiful people. It's time to leave Vieques and head for Calabria. About a 5-hour sail. And yes, we do plan on sailing once we get around Vieques on the east side of Vieques. And it's time to pull the anchor. Michael's getting the map ready. Lola's getting a little more comfortable in her spot. Let's go, baby.
It seems like sailing is, and cruising in particular, is like a journey into the spirit world. For those of you fellow nerds who've ever seen Avatar: The Last Airbender, where when you're in the spirit world, everything is completely dependent on your own mental state. When the character is stressed out or scared, the spirit world is a dark and dangerous place and all the spirits are coming to get you. But when you're calm and cool and just in a really good place, it's a beautiful, magical place where you can have a lot of fun. And that's definitely what sailing feels like as well.
And when I'm like mentally and spiritually in a bad place, sailing is a nightmare. But when you're feeling good, you're living your best life, and you're remembering to breathe and relax, it could be a really enjoyable experience.
Like right now is actually kind of intense out here, you know? The waves are not small when they come together, they're big, and you gotta steer the boat to hit them on a right angle like this one.
Yeah, we're just kind of bashing into them. We're almost around that point, and then it should get a lot more fun. But even now, Michael and I are doing okay.
But we are still having
okay.
Fun with it. It's been a pretty tough beat, but we are finally making it to the edge of the island. We're rounding the point of Vieques. We can see Culebra, we can see Culebrita, and we can even see the USVIs way out there in the distance.
That's good. What do you think? You feel comfortable about with this?
Yeah.
All right. Pretty much at a beam, huh? That's too tight, no. Yeah, it's at a beam, so it should be, remember you want like the curve in the front one third of the sail. But you basically remember, when in doubt, let it out. So you let it out until it luffs. And then once you see it luffing, then you just wind it in a little bit from there. That's probably pretty good. You could, yeah.
It's hot. Whew. Save some diesel, save some oil. God, everything just gets a lot better when the engine's shut off.
This is the first time we've just had the full head sail out. We did pull it all the way out on the way to Coffin Island, but we quickly pulled it in because it was picking up to 18 knots and it was healing us over quite a bit. But right now, this looks like the forecast was correct so far, which is about 10 knots, probably averaging 10 knots of wind. So we got full sails and we're just on a perfect beam reach. This is fun. This is a lot better than beating into the wind. Let's go, baby.
Let's go.
What do you think about sailing, sweet girl? It's a lot more peaceful without that engine, huh?
What do you think?
Why are you hiding from the camera? South side of Vieques was definitely the most crab traps I've ever seen from all the way from Florida. That was just me personally. I've heard there's a lot on the north coast of DR, on the way to Marathon in the Keys, there was definitely quite a few. But south side of Vieques, right about the 40-foot line, when we were out about 60 feet, so we kept seeing them and we were just outside of them, but it was just constant. And I mean, probably 50. We saw 50 or more in a couple hours. And right now I see a few more out here.
Crab pot dodge.
Crab pot dodge. Let's go, baby. So what were you saying this relates to, driving the sailboat?
For me, it relates to driving a combine. Because you really have to steer way out ahead, like kind of anticipate everything. If you're off course and you have to make kind of a big correction to get back on course, it's so much harder to maintain that straight line. You're fishtailing all over the place. So the goal is really to make as small of corrections as possible, but like almost anticipate the correction that you need to make before it comes. So it's more like a feeling, like an intuitive feeling that you get when the wave hits the boat or like you feel the wind you're at one with the boat. It's pretty awesome.
Those of you out there tuning in on a weekly basis, or even just maybe watching this video for the first time, checking out the bums, I'd like to know why you watch. Oh, got the radio. I just like. Ah! I'm trying to. Like to know why you watch. I think a lot of you guys came in because of the boatyard days. Honestly, when we pulled out in the boatyard, we had a low amount of subscribers, and you know, we about quadrupled them by the time we left the boatyard in 1 year. So I think a lot of you tuned in for the boat work. It's so great to have Shock Mate out on the water. The motor's running, we're able to shut it off, and the sails are working. That was a lot of work, so. Jinx. Yeah, the keel has not fallen off. A lot of you were really concerned, as you should have been.
If you're watching this, let us know how that mainsail looks. Is it rigged up properly? You sent us a couple really awesome, kind, detailed messages on Facebook when our outhaul was way too loose and the mainsail was way above the boom. So it's not perfectly parallel with the boom right now, but we feel like we're getting better performance out of it. So I just want to know what you think about what we have going on now.
Gentlemen never sail to weather. It's entirely unsophisticated. See, at this moment in time, I could have a nice brandy. I could even set it down beside me with no fear of it toppling over. But forget about it if you're going into the wind with the motor on. Ugh. Ugh. That's for the common folk.
What happened to your accent?
The common folk!
There you go. What accent is that? Is that English? British? Australian?
No, I don't even know. Australian English? It's weird.
Australian British accent, I think is what that is.
Top of the morning to you.
How are you doing, Lola? That's definitely the happiest Lola has been on any of our sails yet. And I think it's probably a reflection of Joel and I, because we are both having a good time as well. We're almost in, 2 miles out. Culebra, here we come. And that is St. Thomas.
We bought Shock Mate in St. Petersburg, Florida. And the previous captain brought this boat from St. Thomas to St. Petersburg, Florida, where we purchased the boat. So the hailing port is St. Thomas. And we haven't changed the name or the hailing port. And one of our huge bucket list Hail Mary dreams was to get Shock Mate back to her hailing port in St. Thomas. And now it almost seems like we might pull it off. You can literally smell St. Thomas. We can see her with our eyes. That is pretty surreal.
What does it smell like?
Smells like glory.
I'm like a little villain.
Yep, I'm Lola. I'm a sailor and pretty much the boat sails itself. I just tell Joel and Michael what to do. and I just basically chill in my little cubby hole here. And I always take a poop and a pee before we leave. That way I don't have to do it while we're underway.
Oh, that's such a good idea, Lola. I should start doing that.
At least what we're over right now. Alright, we're on the move. We didn't like that anchorage. Bahia Linda. It was really small, and even though we backed it down to about as high as our RPMs will go, our mantis didn't seem to really dig that deep. We were maybe gonna ride it out, but caterpillars really didn't set, and so they definitely weren't gonna stay. So we decided to go around to Ensenada Honda, which is more of the main anchorage. It's really protected, it's a lot bigger. The only downside was caterpillar was not going to be able to make water there, or if they did, it was gonna be a lot harder on their membrane and their filters. So we're just gonna keep on moving. It's about 3 miles to the entrance, maybe 5 more miles. We're just moving. Hey, we're moving further east right now, getting closer to St. Thomas. Is there such thing as a little cute mega yacht? I think that's an oxymoron.
I mean, bigger.
I'm not the reader, I'm not the writer. Was that an oxymoron? Little mega yacht? So this is the new spot, Ensenada Honda. It was about 4 miles from the Bahia Linda, the first attempt. And this is a pretty cool spot. Huge bay, lots of little areas you can anchor. We kind of went all the way to the back end. And this could work. I think we're gonna be here for a couple days.
We made it. Anchored down, dinghy in the water. Food ready. This is some canned chicken, broccoli, rice noodles, and a packet of orange chicken sauce, which is delicious. Our underway foods consist entirely of things that are like quick and easy to make. So the rice noodles and the broccoli, I just boil some water, pour it over those canned chicken and the sauce, throw it all together, and you've got a meal in like 10 minutes, which is awesome. We also do sandwiches a lot too, because a cold sandwich on a hot day is just nice. It's
but
great.
I'd say number one purchase is the chicken, canned chicken.
Yeah.
We never really knew we would like canned chicken so much, but it's so quick and easy, and you have chicken with broccoli or noodles.
It's not great by itself. You know, if you just want to eat a chunk of chicken, you better go for the rotisserie stuff, which we do.
Right, but when you make a nice meal, it's just perfect. We have tons of canned chicken on the boat.
We do.
We are now in Culebra, and we came here because we heard great things about it. It's a special place. Mm-hmm. Looks like there's a lot of cruisers here.
Yeah.
And it also
lots of cruiser boats.
Looks very interesting.
It's really cool so far, just from what we can see. And we're gonna go in and explore in the next episode.
So make sure you subscribe and give us a thumbs up, because that was a cool sale. I know you guys enjoyed that sale, because we did.
Definitely.
So you must have,
mm-hmm.
right? And the wild card anchorage boogie.
Yeah.
The wild card anchorage boogie.
That was the right choice.
It was definitely the right choice. That little thing, that was good for a day. Go there for a few hours and
exactly.
then leave, but you don't want to stay there.
Which is what it said on the chart,
be
fair.
Charts are usually right.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks to our patrons. Thanks to all of you who have been following along. We'll see you guys next week.
All right. Thanks, guys.
These are the tales of BOAB.
Oh, this is wonderfully relaxing. I was just being a goof, and Joel had me get the camera because he thought what I was saying was so poignant. And it was basically just that gentlemen never sail to weather. It's entirely
action.
Gentlemen never sail to weather.